Hi, Cole.
Oh, hi, I'm sorry. You caught me deep in thought trying to figure out why he threw that pitch. Hi, how are you? Thursday morning, Nate and Sean, your morning minute for Mile High Sports. Thank you for stopping by. The Rockies' 2017 season has come to an end due in part to Pat Neshek throwing a belt-high slider on the outside portion of the plate to a relief pitcher. I am containing myself because I spent most of the morning yelling on the radio show about that particular pitch. Sean, not the only problem last night, but that certainly completely deflated what was a great comeback in the works.
Yeah, that really felt like it was the final blow, the pitch by Neshek, and obviously Greg Holland came in and coughed up a few more runs to basically end it. It was not the only problem in the game. Obviously, John Gray came in, gave up 7 hits in 1 3 innings. It looked like a deer in the headlights, quite frankly. Had an opportunity to make his first postseason start, and maybe it looked like the moment was a little too big for him. Also looked a little too big for Charlie Blackmon, for DJ LeMahieu. These are the NL's last two batting champs. They went a combined 0-9 and stranded 7 runners. This is why we talk about playoff experience and how important it is in every single sport. Make sure you can slow things down, get your heartbeat a little slower, and relax and do what you can do. The Rockies looked like the stage, at least for the first half of the game at minimum, quite frankly, a little too big for guys making their first appearance.
And I think it also showed what a difference was, and we talked about this for several months, what the difference was going to be between playing that wild card game in Phoenix and playing it at 20th and Blake. That was obviously something that would have helped them being at home, having that comfort zone. I give them a lot of credit for the fight. I give them a lot of credit for coming back the way that they did, for not giving up. This was a team that I think in the dugout, when it was a one-run game, were sitting back saying, we can win this. And then unfortunately what happened there with 2 outs, the fact that they gave up a total of 4 triples in the game was clearly a problem. Sean, now inevitably, because we are already at this point, we have to start talking about what happens to this roster now going forward. Carlos Gonzalez, Charlie Blackmon, DJ LeMahieu, Greg Holland. There are a lot of names that this organization, Jeff Breidich, all the way up to Dick Monfort, are going to have to make decisions about.
Yeah, obviously Holland and Jonathan Lucroy, Mark Reynolds, these are all guys that are free agents, all starters on the team. Carlos Gonzalez, we've covered it multiple times. It sounds like to me that he's probably on his way out, but you don't know. He finished very strongly, and he played well in the playoff game last night, too. Charlie Blackmon and DJ LeMahieu were up for arbitration. It means they're not going to go anywhere, but it means they're going to need big raises. So the Rockies have financial decisions to make, and they're going to have holes in their roster to fill if they don't get some of these free agents re-signed.
I'm so frustrated. I just can't. It'll be a football Friday tomorrow, even with the Broncos bye week. Maybe that'll cheer me up a little bit. Tune in and find out. 7 a.m. Mile High Sports, AM 1340, FM 104.7. Rockies, I kid, good season. Nobody expected them to do this, especially with 4 rookies in rotation when everything started. It was a good season. Congratulations for that. Now let's turn it into a step and a growth opportunity for this team as we get towards spring training next year. I will be looking forward to that, and I know you will too. For Sean, I'm Nate. We'll see you.